Now, there can't be many young lads from Fleetwood in Lancashire christened with a name as show-stopping, as dramatic, as flourishingly Italianate as Alfred Giovanni Roncalli.
It's very good.
It seemed inevitable that the young Alfie Boe should gravitate towards the opera stage. Cut to 42 years later, Alfie is at the very top of his game. He won a gazillion fans when he serenaded the crowds from the balcony of Buckingham Palace for the 2012 Diamond Jubilee. He's had platinum record sales, 4 top 10 albums, recently starred in classic Quadrophenia, Pete Townsend's lavish orchestral reworking of the classic 1973 rock opera. And later this year, Alfie's off to Broadway playing Jean Valjean Jean in Les Mis. Morning, Alfie. Great to see you.
Good morning. How are you?
Very good. What would you normally be doing?
Can you just pronounce my name again, the middle bit?
Giovanni Roncalli.
That's very, very good.
I've been enjoying saying that all morning.
Can I just ask? Wasn't that the name of Pope John the 23rd?
Well done, Richard.
Oh.
Very good.
Yeah.
Catholic
yeah.
family.
Absolutely, yeah. Catholic family. And I do plan on being the next Pope at some point.
We can talk about this.
Okay.
Let's maybe manage those ambitions. You've turned up in your gym kit. What are you normally doing of a Saturday morning then?
Yeah, there isn't a webcam here as they're filming this all
no.
now. I'm going to the gym. I'm going to work out after this. But you are taking a photograph of me. Thanks very much, Richard.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Smile.
How's that?
Oh, how hovering.
I do plan on going to the gym.
That's very nice.
After
I'm going to
this,
tweet this
session.
Sorry, Richard. We're in the middle of doing a radio program.
He's
taking his photographs of Alfie. So you're either hanging out with the family, doing gymmy stuff, that
yeah.
kind of thing. You're a bit of a gym obsessive, aren't you?
I am. I've got hooked on it. It's really strange. I go 6 times a week. I box. I've been on a crazy no-carb diet. And I packed in drinking about a year ago, so I feel really good for it. I feel fantastic.
Are you any fun to be around?
I'm
be honest.
Boring as anything.
Are you?
Tell you what.
Are you dull?
No. I'm still a good laugh. I think.
It's hard going though. The kind of stuff you do. I mean,
it
classic Quadrophenia is a big old piece, and it's a massive sing for you. You've got to have that kind of physical stamina to be able to get through a part as big as that.
You certainly have to. I mean, that was one of the things that really focused my mind when I got this. When I got the job to do it. The physicality of singing those songs is so important to be strong to be able to do them, because your voice is lying in a certain register. It never gets a break. You're right at the top of the range all the time. I'm singing.
Do not have fear about it. That's the kind of thing that sends tenors into cold sweats, is the idea of having to sing high all the time.
I was on the stage at the Royal Albert Hall for 2.5 hours singing that piece, and I was panicking. Yeah, I was scared. Yeah, but it was fun. You know, when you walk out on stage into an environment like that, and it's beautiful. The whole crowd are behind you, and once you start the tune and you start singing, it just all the worries seem to disappear. And then your colleagues walk on stage, like Pete Townsend walked on and with his guitar, and it was a real surreal moment because I stood there. Pete was in his position where he stood for years on the Royal Albert Hall stage, and I was in Roger Daltrey's position, and it was just really freaky. It was like hallowed ground I was on, sort of thing, you know. And then Billy Idol walked on. He was playing the role of Ace Face in the piece, and he's such a great singer, great character, wonderful energy on stage. It just feeds you with so much emotion and so much joy to be doing what you're doing. And then the guy that played Jimmy in the original movie, Phil Daniels, was also in the show. And so
he's
it was
a
great
of a dude.
He's a wicked fella. He's so cool. And he's in Les Miserables at the moment in the West End playing Thénardier.
Let's just listen to a bit of this fantastic voice. This is Love, Rain Over Me, Alfie Boe singing.
Only love can make it rain the way the beach is kissed by the sea. Only love can make it rain like the sweat of lovers laying in the fields. Love, rain over me. Love,
voice is a little bit special. Look at yours. It's very nice to see a singer listening to their own work and smiling. So often they're kind of recording it. Oh, I didn't get that. No, quite right. Do you actually enjoy listening back to stuff like that?
I enjoy listening to that because it's something that's very close to my heart. You know, I'm very proud of the album. We worked hard on it. And it's something that I've been trying to achieve for many years, is to try and prove this connection between classical music and rock music, you know, because I don't think there's much difference between any genre of music. I think music is music in general, and it shouldn't be categorised. And so being able to prove that this works, you know, putting a classical voice, a classical structure of an orchestra together with something contemporary, it just molds perfectly.
There was a bit of controversy, though, because it wasn't allowed in the classical charts, because it wasn't quite classical enough. There was a bit of a row about that.
It's unfortunate that that's the case. It made it into the American classical charts. You know, the US took it on board.
Lots of examples when it hasn't gone so well. I'm thinking of, there was a lot of albums that went out you'd associate with the sort of great tenors of a previous generation who would just come in and do Yesterday, my troubles seem so far away. And they just didn't
get
it right.
What's not to love about that? That's an album in itself.
I mean, I think because they didn't really feel secure in that music, and I think you do feel secure in
Well, I do. I grew up listening to it. I grew up listening to rock music more than I did classical, you know. And I was influenced by lots of different singers. When I was a kid, my father's record collection consisted of Enrico Caruso to Elvis. You know, we had all these different, but they both sang the same songs. You know, we had Elvis singing O Sole Mio, we had Enrico Caruso singing O Sole Mio, and the Elvis version is It's Now or Never. You know, the song It's Now, and so I found these similarities quite eye-opening for me and inspiring for me to be able to adapt to that side of the music, you know.
Talking about adaptability, though, I mean, you've always kind of been able to go, as you say, between the opera stage and rock and ballads and all sorts of stuff, and also very adaptable in the sense that you sort of live here in the UK. Yeah. Your family's also got a home in Salt Lake City in Utah, in Mormon Central. This was the place that our own Prime Minister called officially the middle of nowhere. What drew you to Salt Lake City?
Well, he has a point, I suppose. Salt Lake is a beautiful place. We have no Mormon connection, even though it's the hub for the Mormon church. But My wife grew up in Salt Lake. Her parents were posted there for work. And I just find it easier to knowing that my family, my wife, my kids are safe and sound with their family, with their friends, when I'm away on the road, rather than them following me around. We're finding that I'm spending more time here in the UK now, so I'm going to get a place back here next year. I can't leave England too long. No, I miss it too much.
But the whole Americana thing. I mean, I love the you know your little boy is called Alfie and stuff. Yeah, is he known as Alfie Junior?
He's Alfie Junior.
Is he?
Alfie Junior. Yeah.
And I sort of can see you maxing out on the whole. You quite like a good look. Are there a few cowboy boots and things stashed away?
Yeah.
You like your boots?
I've got my truck and my Harley Davidson, and I've got my boots.
Have
yeah,
you?
Man, I love it.
How many boots are we talking here?
You like a bit of boots.
You like a bit of wardrobe, don't you?
I do, yeah.
Are you the Imelda Marcus of the cowboy boot? You've got the Mormon Tabernacle Choir.
Yeah.
A tradition of great singing.
Yeah, I did the Christmas concert with them. Me and Tom Brokaw took part in the Christmas concert. And that was a special moment, really. They're huge. One of the things about them is they're huge Les Mis fans. They actually talk to me like Jean Valjean is a real person, which is very bizarre. And I try to convince them that, no, it's just a character in a book, you know, and I'm acting, you know. He says, no, Valjean is amazing. I mean, you, when you die, you'll meet him one day. And he's like, no, I won't.
How many years have you sung that role, Alfie? When did you first do it?
I did it 5 years ago for the 25th anniversary, then a six-month run in the West End, and now taking it back on to do it on Broadway from September onwards.
There was, though, I mean, there was obviously the movie, and I know Hugh Jackman did Valjean in the movie.
Yeah, thanks for that. Cheers. Have a lovely day, everybody.
Yeah, I know. Well, I wanted to, that must have been a bit of a tense night in the Boe household when the call came through. Yeah, I mean, that is so frustrating to have conquered a role.
Yeah, it was a little frustrating. But, you know, in all fairness, I think Hugh did a Hugh did. You know, it was rubbish. He was like, I could have done it far better.
Hugh who?
I'm sorry.
Hugh who? But anyway, you get to go back to Broadway and do it all on Broadway. Is it fun to be able to revisit a part like that? Or does it sometimes think, oh, come on, I know the notes inside out? Or is it, you know, how do you go back to doing it again?
It is fun. It is fun. I think what's going to be fun is that the production that I'm in is completely different than the one that I did in the West End. It's the 25th anniversary production, so it's got a few different fight scenes in it. Choreography is different. There's projections. There's special effects in the show as well. So it's going to be interesting to take it on board from a different angle in that sense. But yeah, a little bit of nerves are kicking in that I want to do it as well as I did last time and take it further if I can. So,
and while you're not collecting boots and worrying about the next role
and boxing and things
and boxing, okay. I understand you're a bit of a foodie. I mean, obviously you're quite kind of careful about the food,
yeah,
and
I am
the carb
now,
thing.
Yeah.
What's the signature dish? The carb-free signature dish.
Carb-free signature dish.
Are you still cooking much?
Are you just
not eating?
No, I do cook, but I've gone crazy on salads. I do all these. Salads now, and one of the things that I saw on TV was that instead of getting a salad bowl, I get a huge chopping board and just put it all on the chopping board rather than in a bowl, because you can get more of the flavour into the leaves and the bottom and things. Instead,
when you were spray painting TVRs in that factory,
yeah,
what would everybody have said to you with that answer? I like to take a big chopping board and just put some salad out.
This is live, isn't it? This really, yeah, they couldn't. Yeah, I wouldn't have survived the
they
day.
They wouldn't
I don't
have been
think.
A bit surprised, because you used to sing arias, didn't you?
I
you
did.
Used to sing Le Donne Mobile to the
did.
Production line at TVR.
I
but
did.
They loved it, Alfie.
I did. I used to sing along to the radio. In fact, that's how I got spotted. The customer whose car I was working on was an old producer, and he said, look, you know, you've got a good voice, you should try and become a singer. So he told me about an opera company in London that were auditioning for their next tour, and so I came down, took the day off work, came down to London, and got taken on as a 20-year-old singer to do a national tour with the Doily Cart, actually, and that was a lot of fun. Then went to music college after that, went to the Royal College of Music, which was a lot of fun.
But do you remember the moment where you sort of thought, this voice that I've got actually is something special, not just singing in the shower or singing to your mum and dad, but where you really thought there was a place to go with it?
It was when I was singing Love Rain on Me at the Royal Albert Hall last week.
Yeah, this might be a career, actually. Yeah. This could work out. Alfie Boe is with us all morning for now. Thanks very much indeed,
thank
Alfie.
You.
If you want to get in touch, we'd love to hear from you today. You can email us saturdaylive@bbc.co.uk. Text us on 84844. You can tweet using the hashtag BBCSaturdayLive. This is Saturday Live with Richard Coles and Suzy Klein. We're joined this morning by Broadway, opera, musical, theatre, belter of great tunes, Alfie Boe. Also by diarist and wonder stuff frontman Miles Hunt, by former army girl, parliamentary candidate and businesswoman extraordinaire Azzy Ahmed. Also by Sylvia Holder, the former PR executive who swapped an easy retirement on the Sussex coast for a life championing a school in one of India's poorest regions. Let's take a look at your texts, your tweets, your emails. They're coming in thick and fast this morning.
Here's one from Rose in London. Alfie, who is your favourite Javert? The baddie that you've played beside in Les Miserables. Invidious question.
Yeah, I'd have to say Russell Crowe. No, sorry. No.
Move on, Alfie. Let the movie go.
My favourite Javert that I've worked with has to be Norm Lewis, the guy that I did the 25th anniversary with. He was incredible.
And is that kind of a fit, or do you think there's something about that kind of black and white contrast between Valjean and Javert that some singers can kind of articulate better than others?
Yeah, I think with the way that Norm played it, I was trying to explain this yesterday. Norm played his character very dignified, played Javert very dignified, very forthright, and of a certain class. So it was a real contrast to Valjean as a prisoner. But when Valjean started to get into more of that sort of dignified character as the mayor, the way that Norm played it was this panic effect. It was almost like he went into shock because he couldn't cope with this comparison that he had, and now that he's lost. So Norm was great to work with on that.
Excellent stuff. I should also say, Sylvia, someone has helpfully tweeted in to say there's a free shower at most motorway services.
Oh, thank you.
you very much. Oh, well, good. Okay. Can I go now?
Good, you're doing your sponge back.
Just stay a while, if you don't mind. Alfie Boe, you mentioned before the client at the factory when you were working for TVR who suggested you audition for Doily Cart.
Yes.
Did you ever thank him?
He got a car.
Yes, but you had a whole career.
He got a really polished car.
You had a whole lifetime's worth of wonder ahead. Did
I know.
Did you ever stop to thank that man?
I thanked him at the time, but, you know, up to now, I've never been able to find him again. So I've put the question out there, where are you? You know, you gave me the opportunity of going into the industry, and no, he's never found him.
He never left you a card?
No, honestly.
If you are that man...
There you go.
Let Alfie know.
He was 110 when he told me. So.
I'm glad you spent extra time polishing the TV.
A really nice car you got. There you go.
That's thanks enough, possibly.
And so apologies on behalf of the network to all of you. But a lot of...
So we've been will have me before his panel at this rate.
And say hello to your mum as well. From
no.
Us. I'm just trying to be nice, you know. Do keep them coming. It's Saturday Live at bbc.co.uk.
Thank you very much indeed to JP. Lovely smoking tattoo, Jane there. Great to have your calls. Do keep your calls, your texts, your tweets and emails coming in this morning.
I say also my picture of Alfie Boe in his gym kit has gone round Twitter and it's excited and elicited quite a number of responses. Somebody here, this is Louise Johnson, I think she's saying, you know you're carb-free, but would you eat the occasional cake?
That's carbs, isn't it? I can't know.
I don't think she's really bothered about the cake, Alfie.
Oh, really?
Carbs,
oh,
really. Right. Desperately wants to give you a cake.
Really? Yeah. Okay, got you. Okay.
Meanwhile, I've never heard cake used in that context. Meanwhile, Nigel in Islington says, please ask Alfie Boe to sing a snatch of Bring Him Home. That would absolutely make my day. Nigel, he's not a performing monkey. People pay thousands for this. You can't just make requests. They're very demanding out there of you this morning,
very
Alfie.
Very tricky one, that number, because much it of is. It is in falsetto. And it's very quiet too.
It is a bit of a tricky song to sing, but there's this. You were singing this morning, weren't you, Richard? I was told.
Magically.
You were singing some opera.
Yes, I was, magically.
Go on. What were you singing?
What was I singing? Yeah. I was singing. It wasn't
See,
opera.
Just, do you like the way I turned that away from
you? Very nice. I was
singing
Belshazzar's
Feast.
Really?
Yeah, the Mini Mini Tikal of Fast. People don't want to know about
you
this.
You sing a bit of that, and I'll sing a bit of Bring Him Home.
Well, as it just so happens, I'd love to, but unfortunately,
oh,
come to the end of the first part of the programme. This is Saturday Live with Suzy Klein and Richard Coles, joined by the golden throated Alfie Boe, the camo painted Azzy Ahmed, Miles Hunt of the Wonder Stuff, and Sylvia Holder of the Panchak Union Middle School.
Could we invite Richard Coles to use his lungs in the proper way? Because Alfie did, in fact, throw down a gauntlet a few moments before the news. This is Reverend Richard Coles singing part of Walton's Belshazzar's Feast. Take it away.
Really not.
Oh, you're so not.
Mine, mine, tickle ufasin.
They put reverb on that.
Wow.
Didn't they? Thank you. Alfie, in return. Come on, bring him home.
Bring him home, okay. How much do you want of it?
Oh, give us a
little
bit. Go on.
Okay. Okay. God on high, hear my prayer. In my need, you have always been there. He is young, he is afraid. How long have we gone?
Now, Alfie, I can...
Brilliant, loved it. Thank you, Alfie.
I can
fantastic.
See what you're trying to do there.
Yeah.
And I've got some ideas for you.
I was wondering if you had any
maybe
tips
we could
on
talk a little bit.
To get the last note at the end, really.
It's a tricky one. I just think you should learn to walk before you run out.
Well, that was all right. I mean,
it's 10 o'clock in the morning. No, you're not allowed to ask a tenor to sing at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Know,
that was beautiful. Adriana Falchi says, Alfie, I saw you in Northern Ireland for the Proms. You sang a Luce van le Stelle. I was in tears.
Oh, it was
hopefully
that bad.
For all the right reasons.
All right, okay.
I didn't want to... Fantastic. Thank you very much. You've made Nigel's day in Islington. That's all we need to know. Thank you for now. I think, Richard, maybe we'll call you back on the singing. Not sure about that.
Suzy, you might think I'm smooth, But this guy is smooth. Hello, Nigel Havers.
No.
Hello. Good morning.
Are you wearing a cravat by any chance at the moment, Nigel?
No, I'm not actually. I'm not going to tell you what I'm wearing because it's very uncool and.
You have to tell us now. You have to tell us.
No, I'm wearing a pair of I'm just going to ask my wife. How would you describe these? Sort of floral. Like they look like curtains, my trousers.
Oh, you're wearing curtains. There you go. Nigel Havers is wearing curtains this morning. Nigel, tell us your story then.
Well, just before I do, JP, I was sorry for the poor woman who had a nose job and didn't tell her parents because she never noticed. It must have been a very bad nose job.
Or a very good one.
Or a very good. Anyway, my story still sends the shiver down my spine. I tell you what, my dad had a lovely old Bentley that it was his pride and joy, you know, and he kept it locked away in the garage in the country. And my parents were away for a couple of weeks holiday, and I had this new girlfriend when I was about 18, and I thought, I'll tell you what, I'll nip up and borrow the car because that will really impress her. So I took the car back down to London, took the girlfriend out in the car. She was very, very impressed, so that bit worked. And then I drove it back to put it away in the garage. And I thought, before I put it away, I'll put it through the automatic car wash. And in those days, it was those sort of rollers that rolled over the car. Anyway, I'm sitting in the car, having put my sort of 2 and 6 in the machine, and the front, the big roller at the front, got caught in the sign of the B of the Bentley at the front of the bonnet. And a whole car lifted up. Eventually, it shredded the machine practically, but it transpired that the B of the Bentley was now sticking right up, looking at the sky. And I thought, I just pretended to myself that it had never happened.
And what did your dad say?
I put it away in the garage, and then my dad never noticed. A, he never knew I borrowed the car, and B, he never noticed that I damaged the car.
Oh, you got away with
it. And 15 years went by. And then I'm sort of having dinner with him, and he said, "My God, look at my car. What's happened to my car?" And I said, "I did that. It just came straight out of my mouth." And he said, "Oh, right, so I'll send it to the garage." And it cost me 400 quid to repair. I mean, I'll never forget it.
Well,
but it was the most awful moment of my life, sitting in his car with a shredding a washing machine. It was just terrible.
Well, I suggest you take those curtains off and put on something decent and get on with your day, Nigel. Lovely to talk to you this morning. Thank you very much for getting
very
in touch.
Very kind of you to ring me back, lovely. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
A man who has to turn to his own wife to describe what he's wearing. Isn't that fabulous? Thank you to Nigel Havers for giving us a ring. Great to hear from him this morning.
Rich from Worthing says, "I went to see Wonder Stuff at Kingston Poly in 87 or 88. There was a guy in the loo plastering on some thick eyeliner before the gig. Imagine my surprise when the band came on and I saw that it was the bass player."
Indeed, it would have been. Bless him.
That's put your slap on, is it, Mary Punters?
And Archie Beaton in Inverness says, "Richard Coles' singing sounded like that of the recently deceased and much missed Christopher Lee." He says, "That is praise indeed, Richard."
Yeah. Not sure
like
how to make
a horror
that
film,
exactly. I don't know. Perhaps we'll leave that talent undiscovered. But anyway, that's it for today. Our thanks to Alfie Boe, to Miles Hunt, to Azzy Ahmed, Sylvia Holder, Katie Derham, and all our guests. We're back next week at the usual time, and our guest is Jenny Eclair. Until then, from all of us, goodbye.
Goodbye.